everybody that grew up playing Mario Party always had a gripe with the game, be it the cutthroat nature of playing with your friends, or just the brutal luck that seems to always come through when you need it least. With close to 1,000 minigames sprinkled throughout the series, Nintendo was bound to have a couple duds in the game. So with that, this is my top 10 worst Mario Party games in the series. Note this does not include handheld Mario Party games, so if there are some bad ones, then let me know in the comments below. Tricky Tires, Mario Party 6. Mario Party 6 is one of the least liked Mario Party games, and I'm not entirely sure why. Personally, I liked it a lot, and it had some solid minigames for sure. One that was less than solid was Tricky Tires, though. The goal is to drive your car to the end of the track through the many obstacles in your way. The catch is you have to use the C-stick and the joystick to turn. I just find these controls miserable and beyond frustrating, making this one an easy way to start off the list. Mecha Choice, Mario Party 9. Mario Party 9 changed up the entire formula to how the main series works, and whether you like it or not, nobody should be arguing that some of the best minigames in this series came out of Mario Party 9. One that is not making that list anytime soon though would be Mecha Choice. Once again, as a theme of this top 10, this game is simply luck based. Pick a door and pray to those spiteful gods that you don't meet your end when you open it up. No skill, no competition, just hope and pray. Road to Victory, Mario Party 8. In theory, as a 2v2 game, Road to Victory is not that bad, and maybe it's not in all honesty. But trying to cooperate with your partner and row together as a team is horrible. Everybody says that Mario Party can ruin friendships because of the star-stealing and cutthroat nature. Well, I disagree. What kills friendships is when you have to try and work together and fail horribly. Castaways, Mario Party 1. Mario Party 1 was a revolutionary game, and is still one of my favorite Mario Party games, just based on the coin collecting aspect that a lot of the minigames seem to have. What's painful about Castaways is that in all my years of playing this game, I have not once been able to figure out how to not go full power when throwing the reel. It makes basically all the coins in the first two rows completely pointless, making this a prime candidate for the list. On top of that, any Mario Party 1 game that has control stick spinning is not my friend. Bomb on Barrage, Mario Party 2. This game is just an ode to terrible controls. Your goal as the three players is to chuck the bomb into the laundry tub the one player is in. But honestly, it's more of a one-on-one battle, because if you're on the side, chances are you have no chance of hitting your target. The controls are pull back and aim with the control stick, but much like Castaways, the power range on this game is either drop it in front of you or to the moon, Alice. End of the Line, Mario Party 3. Going back to Mario Party 3, we have End of the Line. A dual minigame, it basically all comes down to luck. You either pick left or right and pray to the Mario Party gods that it's the correct path. Get three correct paths in a row and you win. No skill, no strategy, just the memory of a 5-year-old and pure dumb luck, and you'll be walking away with your friend's hard-earned coins. Bowser's Big Blast, Mario Party 2. This game is quite simple. Pick a switch, hope that Bowser's eyes don't roll. If they do, you're dead. It's 100% Russian roulette, and being a battle minigame, that's just annoying. You have to put up your own money in which you had no choice in the matter, and now you have a giant Bowser bomb waiting to explode your face. Worse off, they actually brought this game back in Mario Party 4, as if it wasn't bad enough the first time. Random Ride, Mario Party 5. Some minigames just take everything out of your hands, and this is a prime example. In Mario Party 5, Random Ride is a battle minigame that is, although not entirely luck, it's pretty damn close. The rides have strange little names that will give you some indication of if it will suck or not, but they are not exactly accurate. Even better, if you're in first place, you get to pick last, so you are essentially guaranteed a loss. That's always nice to know ahead of time. Beat Goes On, Mario Party 3. The Beat Goes On is a game that is very simple in concept, as most Mario Party games are. The point of Mario Party is after every turn you play 30-second minigames. The shortness is to help keep the pace of the game going so it doesn't take 5+ hours. The Beat Goes On is the exact opposite of pace. The Shy Guy plays a series of buttons on a drum, and then the four players try to memorize the pattern until one remains. through 15 rounds, adding one note to each round. If nobody gets out, this can take easily 5 plus minutes just for one mini game, and one that really doesn't take a ton of effort either. It's just a bad mini game. Tug of War, Mario Party 1. Tug of War, a 3v1 game where you rotate the control stick to pull the rope with one person, having their rotation strength multiplied by 3. Mario Party 1 is probably best known for one thing over everything else: control stick spinning. And unlike Castaways, Tug of War is a lot more ruthless when it comes to your palm. This minigame is not horrible in theory, which I guess is true for most of these things, but the issue is the blisters you get from rotating the control stick as fast as you can. And with it being a 1v3 game, if you are playing with 4 human players, then it really just comes down to a test of will, because one of you guys is going to burn a hole in your hand and you're going to lose your money to boot. Thank you guys for watching. As always, leave a comment below with the mini games you hated the most through the series. Maybe share some of the mini games you liked the most, and maybe a couple stories from your Mario Party days, I don't know. As well, if you are really interested, then check out me, my friends Lyle and Cayenne, a no-holds-barred game of Mario Party. It's a good time for all. Well, minus Cayenne. It's never a good time for him.